Hi! Yes, I know, this video is a bit late, but I was on vacation and didn't want to interrupt my What's New series. That's why I'm still making this video to show what's new in the August release of Home Assistant 2024.8. Let's take a quick look. It's already August 2024 and Home Assistant has added some great new features in release 2024.8. In this release, the badges have been revamped. They now resemble the chips in mushroom cards and it's starting to look like I can finally replace my old dashboard with the new sections combined with these new badges. Additionally, there's now a new custom badge in the mushroom collection, namely the mushroom template badge, allowing you to fully customize the badges to your liking. To use the template badge, you must have the mushroom cards installed via Hex. When you create a new section's dashboard view, you will see an option at the top to add badges. You can choose an entity and customize it as desired. You can also set the visibility. Here I'll show an example where my person badge is only displayed when I'm home. Additionally, you can drag and drop the badges to place them wherever you want. And since I have the custom mushroom cards installed, I can also create mushroom template badges, giving me complete flexibility. Ultimately, your dashboard can look something like this. As you can see, the cards have also been slightly compressed in this release, allowing you to display more information at a glance on your dashboard. Once I've replaced my old dashboard with all the options that sections offer, I'll make a video on setting up a dashboard that works well on both your tablet and phone. In the past, you could call services in Home Assistant using the call service command. However, services is a bit of a confusing term because, for example, you also have weather services. That's why the Home Assistant team decided to rename services to actions. For instance, the Services tab in the Developer Tools is renamed to Actions, and in Automations you can now use the command Perform Action instead of Call Service. But don't worry, your old automations that use the Call Service command will continue to work. When you edit an existing automation that uses the Call Service command, it will automatically be converted to the Action command. Additionally, there's a new feature added. The actions in the Home Assistant Core integration generic Turn Off, generic Turn On, and generic Toggle. So now you don't have to think about the type of device or entity you want to turn on or off. These three actions figure it out for you. This way you can turn on lights, switches and toggle helpers on or off simultaneously with just one action. Starting from this version, it is now possible to sort your data tables by the created or last modified date. This allows you to easily see which devices were most recently added to your system. Keep in mind that the created and last modified dates are only being stored from this release onwards, so initially this sorting may not have much effect. Since this version, Home Assistant also supports local large language models with the help of Ollama. I have to admit that I haven't looked into this yet, so I can't show it on my own system just yet. But as soon as I have it working, I will make a separate video about it. As with every new version, the August 2024.8 release of Home Assistant has added several new integrations. You can find them in this list. Additionally, existing integrations have also been updated. For example, you should now be able to adjust the chime settings in the Rear-Link integration, but unfortunately, I don't see this option in Home Assistant for the chime connected to my Rear-Link video doorbell. I have no idea why it's not visible for me. If you know why, please let me know in the comments. Furthermore, there have been updates to ZHA and Meta, and KNX can now be managed through the UI. In addition to the integrations, there are other changes worth mentioning. You can find them in this list. For example, you can now also ask Assist for the date and time. In the past, integrations created via YAML in the configuration.yaml file could not be seen in the Home Assistant UI. Starting with this release, that's now possible. These integrations will now appear in the integrations overview. They are marked with a special icon indicating that the integration was activated via YAML. The same applies to helpers created in YAML. So, that was my quick overview of the changes in Home Assistant 2024.8. Now it's time for me to start adjusting my dashboard so that it fully works with sections. Thanks for watching. If you enjoy my work and want me to continue doing this, you can support me on Patreon, Ko-fi, or by becoming a paid member of my channel. You can find the links in the description of this video. These people are already sponsoring me and helping me to keep this channel going. Thank you all. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye bye. Okay. So.